Velocity to Game. I think it's something special here today, something that I'm showing more than three or four people watch videos. I gotta crack my shits complaining bitterly, but how dare you do this? Today we're talking about Hop Nation Brewing Co. That's alcohol for the non-hipsters who aren't based in Australia. The Forager Blueberry Napier. The Archie Blows. There isn't really any necessity in this part of the world for ingredients and all that. Allergens maybe, but that's it for beer. It's a shame. This brand blew up about 2 years ago down under. And they based in a western Melbourne suburb called Footscray. There's a particularly famous market in that part of the world, and they did a beer called The Market and Jedi Juice. I tried Jedi Juice because the market, it sold out instantly. That's when the brand became famous. So when I found out they were up to it again, I thought, oh geez, I gotta try that. Now I know you Americans out there know Napier is New England, something pale ale, Indian pale ale. We'll snort, giggle and scoff. That's absolute horse shit. Unfortunately, in Australia, most hipster brews are Napiers. And I've got to concur, from Mike's limited experience, a lot of them are shit. Nauseatingly so. Let's hope this is a good one. It is not. See, it's 6.5% alcohol by volume. I swear to God, you detect every last bit of that. It is sharp, it is crass. You can definitely tell it's alcohol, there's no hiding from that. Flavor wise, it's blunt, it's crude, it's hoppy. Honest to God, I wouldn't know if there was blueberries there if you bloody ground some up and toss some in the can. If I had to give it a flavour, I would say it's a lesser cousin than Jedi Brew, which to me tasted like hops and this sort of malty fruit, vitamin fortified breakfast juices. You know, guava, apple, pineapple, maybe a hint of passion fruit. You know, the sort of stuff that gives you explosive diarrhea if you haven't had it, and most people probably haven't had it for years and years and years. So, this beer is, it's like a poor cousin to its cousin. A poor relation to its cousin, which tasted like that, which was okay. Drinker, so what do I care? This is this is revolting if you don't want your beer to taste like the bitter, almost fruity tang of hops. This is for something for people who pretend to be connoisseurs or I know, chain smokers who have no sense of taste. Do anyone else, if this ever comes up again, avoid it like the plague. It is bloody miserable. This brand has a really good reputation. This is a horrible, horrible disappointment. And if it does come around again, I bet yet again it's going to be a very limited batch, very hard to find, and it's going to be some miserable bastard out there who wants $8 or $9 a can. Because they know they're one of a handful of places where you can still buy it because they didn't pre-sell all their inventory to regular customers. You can quite literally tell them to get fucked. This is swill. If you want such cheap and nasty beer, you might as well spend what $1 is a crazy cheap price of say $3.50 a can. And just settle for that garbage. Don't pay some arsehole $8 or $9 a can. I don't think, you know, I didn't, but still for the quality, even I paid too much, so I'm which one a lot of people, most people want for one's first alcoholic review, but it is life. They bastard out.